of the hardest things about interior design is the number of tasks that we have to manage throughout our project. We also have to manage the back end of our projects, and this task management can get quite complex. So I use a Notion database to manage our tasks. Let's have a look. So here we are in our Notion hubs. We have our daily dashboard. We've got the widgets that we installed at the very beginning, our to-do lists, and we could actually link these to our tasks, but I use it just a to-do list for tasks that I don't need to store. We've got our quick links, our daily habits, and our post-it notes. Then we have our area that we're going to actually include our tasks. So you can see here, I've split the tasks into two sections, a quick capture task list and an urgent task list. These are just two views of the main task database. When we come up here to this database, we've got our master link database, our project database, our materials database, which we're yet to make, but we also have our standard operating procedures database, and right down here is our master tasks database. These two sections are going to be views of this master task database, and we're going to spend a bit of time just setting them up. Let's just have a quick look at our model again. Here we have our task database, and we're going to split it into columns. So the first thing we're going to do is split it into categories. Now you can categorize whatever you like. So I usually categorize it in terms of content. What actually is that task going to do? Is it to do with social media? Is it to do with the project? Is it to do with setting up our standard operating procedures? Do we have to order office supplies? The next column that we will use is our due date. It's a date column. So these orange columns are really just select columns. And our white columns are just text columns. We have a text box here which says task, the category, the due date, the priority is going to be a select. These in green are all going to be databases which we are going to connect with relations. And these two columns here are checkboxes. So if it's a team task, we know the person responsible has to be a team member. And so you can see here, we've got a context database and another context database. So this part of the context database is renamed responsibility. So we'll only choose a staff member who will be responsible for that particular task. Here will be contacts, that is anyone that we might need to contact just to make it easier. The last thing that we're going to connect is our standard operating procedures. Let's say you have a certain task, such as buying accessories for a project, and you have a standard operating procedure to actually do the purchase order. Instead of just giving your staff member the task without any backup, if they get stuck, you can refer them to a standard operating procedure so that they can do that job according to your standards and be more efficient. Have a look at where we left off last tutorial. We created this projects database. You can see here we've got this task area. So we have a view of my task. So if I click on this, we head to the main description, and you can see we've got our task name, then a checkbox. I say captured, which basically means that if I've actually allocated it to someone, so I haven't actually included that in this list, but you can certainly do that if you like. Then we have our categories. We've split into these sections. So it could be something like clients. It could be to do with our standard operating procedures. It could be with sales operations, whatever you like to do and however you would like to categorize. We have our list when it's done. And we also have a due date, which we can then link to a calendar if we want. So you could actually create another view, and we'll do that in a minute, and base it on this calendar. Then we have we haven't actually done this, but we are going to link it to a goals tab. So if there's something to do, like, for example, I say grow my YouTube channel, and this is a particular task, so you can see make a video on tasks and goals, and that is linked to my goal here, but we can create this in a subsequent tutorial. Then we have our priority. One of the things that we could do is we can mark this as urgent. If you actually have a look at here, you'll see this has appeared in this section here, the urgent task. This is a view of the main task database, and this is another view of the main task database. So we can go in here and create a calendar. So let's just go into here and create a view, and then we're going to edit the view, and then we're going to make it a calendar, and then we're going to rename it and call it calendar. This section here, I call it a quick capture, which basically means that if I want to very quickly just jot down a whole list of tasks, I use it quite differently to the to-dos. The to-dos, I think, are things that you really don't need to be part of this database. You might have tasks where they're just so basic, such as pick up milk, buy toner, whatever might happen. And you may choose not to clog up your task list with these small unimportant tasks. So we have our notes, so we can write any notes that we have, and then we can then create these relations. As we can see here, we've got our contact database. I can say our contact here could be the staff member. I might want to actually rename this to staff responsible, or just responsibility, maybe. Responsibility. Then I could actually create another view. So let's just add in, we don't want to do that. We want to add in a relationship. And then we want to do our contacts. Here we are here. And we probably don't want to show it on our database because we've got it twice, but we can add a relationship here. But you can if you want. You can click that on and it will show it. But here could be just the contact that you have to make for this particular project. Then these two, you can see here, this is linked to the project database. Then we have the project task name, and we have got a link into the project database. So let's just have a look at our project database. And you can see in here, we should have a link, do we not? Hold on, let me just go in here. Let's see, maybe we didn't link it. Let's say we add another relation and we want to link it to my tasks, and I want to put it in here. This is a tasks here. Let's just go back to the task database. And we should be able to see this project gallery here. So then we can just move there. And this is a project name. This is just a select. So this is probably a little bit extra. And then we've got a project task name. This is the relationship that we have. So it's related to this section here of this project name. We also created, at the end, I also created a list which is team tasks. And this is so that this is a view on a separate page of the same database. I don't want it clogging up my task list. So I've actually just added it as a page here and called it team tasks. You can make that stand out a little bit more obviously by putting a heading if that's what you wish. But it just gives you an idea of who's responsible for what in a quick way if you do need that. So thank you for joining me in this tutorial. Task management is a very, very complicated thing for interior designers, and you can certainly make that task list as complex or as simple as you like, depending on the complexity of your project. In the next tutorial, we're going to start winding our Notion database up. We're going to do a few things, such as create the materials, fixtures, and fittings database, as well as a few other small tasks such as a branding guide and goals. So I hope you'll join me in the next tutorial. See you then.